RocklandWorldRadio.com.
We put the rock back in Rockland.
RocklandWorldRadio.com.
I'm independent. You know it. You love it. You can't live without it. Rockland World Radio.
Welcome to Changing of the Guards. This is a, we're back to our regularly scheduled time. And I wanted to mention at the top of this show, something I've been forgetting to mention. But this is the 14th season of Rockland World Radio.
Wow.
On at Nyack Village Theater. And we're very, very privileged and
to be a
part of it, definitely. I wanted to ask you guys a question. Does this beard match my nose?
Does it match your
in
nose?
In what way?
Well, in the way that a lot of girls I talk to, they go, why don't you shave your beard or at least a little
don't
closer because I want to see what you look like. And I realized this kind of early on, is women want you to do that because they don't want other women to be attracted to that maniac wolf that they were attracted to.
It depends, like on, like the proportion of like your beard to your nose. Like the bigger your nose, the bigger your beard.
Well, this is another thing. Let's talk about the proportion of my chin to my nose. I unfortunately don't have a chin. And just a huge nose. And this is what I tell the girls. Yeah, this is what I tell the girls. If I shaved my beard, I'd look like a Simpsons character.
Do me a favor. Like,
and
straight on, look at me.
Yeah?
Look at
me. I don't know.
Dude, you haven't seen... Well, I did shave that one time in the lounge.
Yeah.
But I literally look like a Simpsons character, and I'm getting older now.
I would rather have a big nose than a Jay Leno chin. And that's just me.
Well, no. Wait, you'd rather have... Would you rather have a no chin or a Jay Leno chin?
I'd rather have no chin.
You'd rather have no chin?
I mean, like... Yeah.
But the thing is, I always tell these girls that, look, like, if I were to shave for you... Then I'd have no chin, I'd have a big nose, and next thing you know, you'd be thinking things like when you're kind of performing your duties, you'd be hearing in your head, ew, Smithers, can you do that thing with your tongue again?
I mean, I grew up for most of my life with, like, multiple chins, so...
Oh, that's right.
I'd rather have no chin.
You have a Jeff Garland, you had a Jeff Garland thing going before.
Yeah, I had, like,
this.
A Kevin Spacey.
Right.
Chin.
Well, no, Jeff Garland, the guy, he's the sidekick on the Larry David show.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah.
That reference went right over my chin.
Right under. Just
like a
John Papelbon pitch. So, what's up, everybody?
Oh, man. So, I am glad to be back.
We got Michelangelo back in the house.
Yeah, I'm especially glad to be back on the show with my boy. On to the far left of me, whose code name I'm forgetting.
Khan.
I forgot
Khan.
It too.
Khan. Shao Kahn, that's right.
And just to like clear stuff up from last week, I didn't forget this guy's name, I forgot his alias.
Yes, yeah, that thing.
The Wrath of Khan.
And yes, I'm really glad to be back. My stepfather had a major surgery last week. He had his hip replaced, and so the whole week I've basically been having to take real care of him, and it's just been tough. I've had to go all over, get his prescriptions and make sure that his physical therapist shows up every day and set up appointments, blah blah blah. So I've been busy, but I'm back on the show and he's doing well, and I'm ready to ready to have a good time.
Let me know how well he's doing, because I could use some of his painkillers.
Yeah.
I'm in a lot of pain.
You know, my mother actually told him that she wanted him to switch from Percocet to another painkiller because she thought it was making him crazy.
Really?
Yeah.
He must be, if he had hip replacement, he's on the Percocet 10s.
He's been.
Those are so much fun.
He's been drugged. He's been drugged up pretty good. And he was in a lot of pain, like, right after the surgery.
Michelangelo was saying that his father was being high maintenance. I said, slip him two. That'll all go out the window. He'll just be like, can you get me 50 McNuggets, man? And put on the Larry Sanders Show. I miss that.
Mm-hmm. I'm glad that he's, like, back to his old self, because, like, for the first couple days, he was just really, really out of it. But, I mean, the other day, we had a conversation, and he was, like, he was talking about my dog, and he was like, well, I had my knees replaced, and I had my hip replaced, but at least I'm not a eunuch.
Good, yeah.
Like the dog.
Out of lemons.
And my dog was like right on the bed, and he was like, "You better be careful, or he's gonna fuck you right in your hip replacement."
Oh God! Wow.
For real.
So wait. So so he had a knee replacement and hip replacement.
He's like the bionic man. Yeah.
Wow. I know that. I know that Prince had the hip replacement, and he was back up and dancing a little while ago, but I'm not sure if it was his appetence or his drug addiction. I don't know what helped out, but it seemed like he never missed a day, and then he died.
I think it depends. Like, some people come back sooner than others. It's going to take my
step. Wait, who do you think Prince is going to be reincarnated as? Oh, you mean come back in a different way?
I think Prince is going to be reincarnated as the lead singer for Queen. I think that would be like a very ironic sort of.
That'd be pretty, yeah.
Yeah.
And then
they go on to form a band called King. Like,
ooh, wow.
That would be like meta.
You know, I saw Freddie Mercury at a Wendy's by like Monroe.
No, you didn't.
No, you didn't.
Yeah. There's a guy
who looks exactly like Freddie Mercury.
Yeah, and he had the.
What, like horse teeth and a mustache?
Yeah, he did. He had it all. He had the hair, the teeth, the fucking nose, and...
Does he have a voice? That's all I give a shit.
I don't know.
Yeah. Could he, like, rock Live Aid?
If he has the voice, tell him to, like, get him and Brian May to, like, brutally beat Adam Lambert to death and hide them in their trunk, like, Goodfellas style, and then just, like, take over.
I visited that same Wendy's. I visited that same Wendy's, like, multiple times to, like, see if I could find this guy again.
Right.
And I have not been able to see him. It was like...
Well, I don't think Freddie Mercury was as much noticed for his looks as he was noticed for being, like, probably easily in the top three, maybe top five greatest performers of all time.
Yeah. Oh, for sure. Not a question about that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, Iggy Pop, Tomato Duplenty from The Screamers. Now I'm getting esoteric.
Yeah,
but Warren Ellis from The Dirty Three.
Your references are going over everyone's head.
One, I'm not a huge Primus. I mean, I am a Primus fan, but I saw them in Irving Plaza in the 90s, and I think Les Claypool is one of the greatest performers.
Yeah, Les Claypool is really cool.
I'm just naming all these awesome performers I've seen. But Warren Ellis from The Dirty Three. Anybody, if you haven't heard The Dirty Three, listen to The Dirty Three. But anyway, I wanted to talk about if any of you guys know about Ahmad Khan Rahami.
I haven't done that in a long time. I used to whenever I was in the lounge and I used to talk like politics, like Middle East politics, I would always like spread the spittle like Hamas, Hamas that.
Well, he wanted to like we had a skit sketch written about you. God bless you, Rich. about you. Choking while saying
choking on the
on the word Hamas.
I was in class like the other day, and I had like I had like these. I have like these two Jewish girls sitting in front of me, and there was.
Wait, what class?
I'm taking a math class.
Where?
Back at Rockland.
Yeah. Back at the lounge.
Really? Yeah.
When?
As it turns out, I couldn't get my transfer to Baruch in time. So.
Of course you haven't.
Baruch. Yeah. Baruch. Baruch. Baruch atah.
What days are you there, man?
Just Tuesday and Thursday.
Oh, he's
opposite
he's,
of me.
He's opposite.
Oh yeah, but yeah. I'm only there at night, so I wouldn't really be there anyway. But no, I have these two like Jewish girls sitting in front of me. We'll get back to Achman real quick, but I just wanted to tell this over. And there was this kid like next to me eating a bag of Skittles, and the.
Oh, sorry. I'm just doing my pre-show warm-up. You got here a little late today, people.
Lubing it up.
Yeah, just.
And he was like, oh, like you want some? And they were like, no, they're not kosher. And he was like, yeah, they are. And they were like, no, they're not. And I was like, no, if they were kosher, they would be called Skittles instead of Skittles. And they were like, that's so racist. And I was like, I'm Jewish. I'm allowed to make that joke.
Get the fuck.
Come you, on. You had your game-changing yarmulke in your pocket, I bet you.
Like, yeah. What now? Racist no more.
Like the Jewish hammer just start.
Yeah.
Right in their mouth.
Yeah, exactly.
I didn't even mean for that to go that way.
It went that way, though.
But anyway, so there was a bombing. Look, I've kind of been evading news stories and stuff like that. And today I was like, you know what? Like, we got a show
seems
today.
A little relevant. You know?
Let's talk about. Let me. I just.
He's in custody now.
I actually. Yeah. Well, they shot the shit out of him. I heard. So he was. So I just said news in Google. That was
really
I didn't go to 7-Eleven and get the New York Times. I just went news, and then suddenly I realized New York City was bombed.
Yeah.
Well, no. I mean, I shouldn't be doing that. Most people can do whatever they want, but you know, we have a show. But then I went, holy shit! And the next thing you know, I'm reading all these stories about how you know 29 people were messed up. There was another one in Jersey, but we're from New York. Who cares about Jersey? But anyway, But yeah, but this guy.
What happened in Jersey?
I used to. I remember when I lived in Bowery. I used to jog all the time until I realized I have no reason to jog until I start getting, like, you know, a belly or something.
Yeah, no.
Actually, I think I'm starting to get A cups. I don't know, but yeah, like I. So you know, like it just kind of makes you think, like, oh, I could have been jogging by Chelsea.
You know, like,
and next thing you know, but I had something worse happen to me than a bombing. There was this black dude outside selling stuff, and he said, "Yo, white boy, you want any stuff?" And I said no, and I have my shorts on, and I have really skinny legs, like embarrassingly skinny legs.
Okay.
And so I went, nah, Matt, and I just kept running, and he went, fucking faggot. And I never jogged again. I just sat under the stairwell
the
of my
trauma.
Yeah, I sat under the stairwell of my apartment crying, like, do I really look like that? Black man
called me faggot, so you know it's true.
No, it's true. Maine.
I think in like the larger scheme of like the looming election, I think that it really plays into like Donald Trump's hand. I was speaking to my stepfather, and this whole time I've been saying pretty much like Hillary's gonna win. For the first time since the beginning of this election, and you might think I'm crazy, I actually think Donald Trump is going to win now.
Really?
Because I've said from the start that this is Hillary's job to lose, and not only is she doing everything that she can possible to lose it, but I think everything that is happening in current events is just really bolstering Donald Trump's sort of it's mobilizing his base, I think.
I don't think so.
You don't think so?
I think Hillary's going to. Hillary.
Hillary.
I have a friend who posts that all the time. Like, I have one of my friends, he's a black dude, and he's always saying, you know, I don't know. I forget what he calls him, Trump is shit, whatever. But it's like, I'd rather vote for him than Hillary.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. And like Trump is such a like ignorant, he looks like an ignorant racist. So it kind of, it's interesting to me that, you know, this is like a dude, he's very into
politics.
Well, not necessarily into politics. He's just, he was all over the Kaepernick thing.
He's
just
he's into like race black issues.
Dude. Yeah, he's a very proud black dude. So,
but I mean, like, you know,
like it's interesting to make that choice.
It's interesting, and I'm curious as to why people sort of swing the way they do. But at the same time, like, I think, like, especially with, we have to realize that, you know, people aren't sort of like a monolith. Like the black vote isn't like a block. Like, okay, it's probably true that most of the black vote in this country is going to vote for Hillary Clinton. That's probably going to be the case. But at the same time, it's not like a block.
Well, also the Jewish community. I mean, look at what she did in New York.
Yeah, the Jewish community when she was a
senator.
A Hasidic Jew. I thought you were about to say.
Yeah, she was practically, because a lot of the votes she got in New York was her pandering to that audience.
Right.
So
I mean, that's how she gets most of her votes.
Well, it's politics. That's the way it is.
Politics is usual. I feel like I want to give people like that, like. That credit, like they're not as stupid as like they, you know. Because how can you not see someone like lying through their teeth and just be like, yeah, like, you know, like pandering, like you. I feel like you could see that shit like a mile away, like especially with Hillary, because like she does it so boldly and so clumsily that you're just like, hey, look at me, I am pandering.
But haven't you guys noticed that, like, people who are actually like really into politics? They're only into it for 2 years, maybe a year and a half, years.
All in the election cycle.
You end up talking to your friends, and for 2 years, it's just all politicians are the same. They're all just backed by big banks. You know, that's why it was awesome to see Trump do what he did to get this far, because
just to show the anti-establishment. Sort of politics can thrive in this country.
Well, yeah, like you can, yeah, exactly. Like, it was fun just watching him.
Well, I mean, like, look, like
just speak his mind.
In England, Brexit was like a huge victory for anti-establishment.
By the way, how do you? Well, actually, no. The more I've been studying about the Brexit, the more that I realize. A lot of British people or people from the UK that I'm friends with, you know, I guess it's just like a younger. We took a very conservative approach to this, but I'm on the fence right now because I think that the UK alienating itself from the European Union.
I mean, I'm not saying definitively whether it was 100% right or 100% wrong.
Like, because we both talked about how we were proud of England for keeping their sovereignty.
I would have voted for Brexit if I had had the choice. But I had made this a caveat that I think that there are valid arguments for both sides, and I think there are valid reasons to stay and to leave, and I think that. Like a lot of people's livelihoods were kind of in the balance
right there.
So I wouldn't fault anybody for voting any particular way.
I mean, really what it's about is, should there be unity in Europe? Kind of like, I think like a lot of, I mean, especially I'm... like artists, they want to see Europe pull together like, you know, the United States should have. I mean, we're very, you look at, you know, the blue and red states, we're all over the place in America. But I think that, and who knows, I mean, I always think about that Churchill quote, that if you're not a liberal at 20, you have no heart, and if you're not a conservative at 40, you have no brains. And I might be 40 soon, and...
You're still a liberal.
Yeah, no, I don't think I have any brains. No, but anyway, but that's... I feel like the 40-year-olds wanted the sovereignty and the 20-year-olds wanted the unity.
I mean, I can... Like I said, I can hear both sides. I just... I think it... at least in my opinion, I felt that it was... I have no problem, like, with the people of Europe being united. I don't think that that's really what... that that's really the issue when it comes to that. I thought it was just like a matter of government. It was a matter of who is going to govern us, and the idea of having like one singular entity have like that much centralized power is not. You know.
No one nation should have all that power.
No, but it was really all about should we.
Should we
collaborate with our neighbors, make a better Europe, or should we say fuck out of here? The pound has always been one of the strongest currencies in the world, if not the strongest. And the pound, you know, it took a dive afterwards. I'm sure it's kind of gaining its momentum. I encourage anybody from America who always wanted to go to London, go now, because you know they're down at this moment.
Yeah, give their economy a boost, you know, whatever you can.
Give the economy a boost, but also the dollar actually means something in England. This is coming from somebody who lived there for almost 3 years. I got killed in the exchange rate for all the money that I made the summer before I went to college. I got killed. You know, it was like 75 cents to every dollar, basically. So wow. You're paying $2 for everything.
Yeah.
I had a friend, my friend Chuck, the dude that I wrote with. And now we're suddenly talking about the Brexit. I love how I have all these segments and then we always end up talking about something completely different. But I remember my friend saying the first time he was at a pub, sorry, Melon, but the first time he got to England, he did the same like European adventure I did with another friend of ours. And he had that whole, you end up in England and you're at a pub and you're like, oh, £2? That's all it is for a drink? And then 2 hours later, you're like, $200? That's how quick that goes?
Just the theme, I guess, was sort of anti-establishment politics, and I feel that that vote, whether you agree with it or not, or whatever your rationale behind it was, I think was a victory for the anti-establishment, because I do think the establishment in Europe wanted to stay. I mean, like, the prime minister the prime minister at the time made it very, very clear, like, we want to stay.
He resigned the next day.
Yeah, he resigned the next day.
Yeah.
So in that sense, I think it's a victory for the anti-establishment. Do I think it was the right decision? Well, time will tell. But, you know, that's a different discussion for a different day. What I think kind of is worrying is that after what happens, and this is like New York. And I mean, like, I think New York is going to swing blue no matter what. I really don't see us.
Oh, doing. Yeah, sure. Well, the further you go upstate, it's a different story. But we got the numbers.
Yeah, exactly. So yeah. I think we're going to swing blue no matter what, unless, I don't know, Hillary says all New Yorkers are a bunch of cunts. But, you know, outside.
And we are.
Outside of that, yeah, I'm sure some New Yorkers, we are.
Oh, people from Buffalo think we're cunts and we think they're cunts. But, you know, at the same time, I was talking to Sammy about this.
Mm-hmm.
I think the only reason why the word cunt is a bad word in America is because the last thing the Puritans heard before they got kicked out of off the island before the Renaissance was, all right, get out of here, you cunts. Practice your religion somewhere else, you cunt.
Yeah. That's
I like
fair.
It. It's a good thing it became like a bad word, I think, because like saying it, it's so fun.
Oh, it's a beautiful word. Yeah. Just like Louis C.K. said, it's just mellifluous.
It's a fun word to say. I mean, fuck is still like my favorite curse word.
But you also have to distinguish. You can't, like, in America, you have to like know the difference between calling a man a cunt and a woman a cunt.
Yeah.
It's just it's different.
Well, I mean, like, what's the difference between me calling a man a bitch and a woman a bitch, right?
Yeah.
It's
more of a gendered insult.
You think you could use cunt, like, in, like, say, like, dirty talk and sex?
In England, yeah.
Okay.
In the UK. I don't think America's too young of a place to accept that word, I think.
Yeah.
How old do we have to get?
I think we need to...
Not past the age of consent.
There needs to be some genocide to the white people this time, and then we can start saying cunt.
It's pretty much happening in social media for them, so...
Really? I don't think it's the same kind of genocide.
No.
I think being ostracized on social media. You mean like
actual boots on the ground.
Yeah. Or, yeah, just a good boot to the nuts, maybe. Mm. Mm. Something like that.
I guess Jews could use it.
But anyway, Ahmad Khan Rahimi. Anybody study anything about this man?
No.
And you think it's auspiciously in Trump's favor?
I don't think it's auspiciously in Trump's favor. I just think it's in Trump's favor. Because I think people are going to see that and they're going to be like, hey, like, I mean, again, it happened in New York and we're going to swing in blue no matter what. So I don't think it's going to be as significant as...
But with media these days, it's going to spread like wildfire. And there's going to be a lot of, see? You know, I remember, like, this article I read.
I feel like it kind of blew over, though, because nobody actually died.
Yeah.
Somebody has to die for it to become, like, a big deal.
Like, right. My issue with it is, like, when I heard about it, like, when it came to, like, I mean, it's totally just, like, my feeling about it. Like, I wouldn't say it's, like, everyone's. But when I heard about it, I guess, like, there was such, like, a numbing effect that, like, I was just like, oh, really? And that's it. Because, like,
Yeah,
because
exactly.
of 9/11? Or, yeah. Fuck, I said 9/11. I hate that word. the attacks in September 11th, 2001.
I don't even know if it could have something to do with that. But, like, I heard about it and, like, you know, in the way, like, maybe when I heard about it, I didn't hear about, like, any deaths. That could have been it. Like,
it was 29 just, like, injuries in New York. Mm. Yeah. Like I said, who knows what happened in Seaside and who gives a shit.
Right. Like,
They're from New Jersey. Screw them. I'm being such a dick.
My thing is just that, like, I saw it.
Yes, I'm a cunt bitch. I love it. I'm a dirty cunt bitch, everybody.
I heard about it, and, you know, it gave no effect to, like, my feelings on just... what I want to say, really... My feelings on it is just the same. Like, anytime I hear about these things, it's just like, yeah, it's an awful thing. But last thing I want to happen is just that, like, people take, you know, this sort of thing and just, like, look at the religion and just be like, hey, you know, this is clearly, like, you know.
Well, I heard at first that they were linking, that he had no links, and now... Cuomo's trying to find the links.
Yeah, and that's what I mean. Because, like, that's what I heard.
People
about.
Are just going to use this kind of thing to as Al-Qaeda an excuse to curtail, state. Well, to curtail our rights. I mean, I just saw, I texted you Saturday night. I saw Snowden, the new Oliver Stone.
Oh, yeah, yeah, right. I want to see that really bad.
Oh, it was fantastic. Joseph Gordon Levitt did a great job. But yeah, I saw Edward Snowden and. You know, for people that aren't familiar, even though I'm sure everyone has heard his name, he was the whistleblower, the hacker who...
him and Assange were one and the same.
Who dished the details about the NSA's prison program and how they were using programs to spy on every single person in the country. Mm-hmm. They have the capability to, like, turn on your webcam and watch you through that. And I mean, like, that's, like, scary stuff.
There's some people that look at it and they'd be like, whatever it takes to, like, you know, protect the American citizens.
Well, he was like, yeah, like, Julian Assange is the left wing and he's the right wing. They both used leaks.
And they're just like, we need this.
I think Snowden was... conservative. I think he's a libertarian.
No. He's okay. Well, yeah, but if
honestly, if the NSA like were to look at my webcam, like they'll look at me jerking off to like horse porn videos, and it's like what are you really gonna get like from looking at like
wow? Last show we had I think 3 Oliver Stone references. We're just this is like Oliver Stone month. Oh, he's a Virgo too. Oh my god. No, but anyway. But yeah, but
I'm sorry.
He's having sex with a horse in there. Brr, Wilbur. But
oh god.
But Snowden. Okay,
you
so
be careful,
so
you're gonna be Elmer's glue in a minute.
So yeah, I mean, I think that like there was a part of me that made like signed a contract with myself, going, all right, stuff's like messed up now, so. They're going to...
I'm not
going
to let it, like, affect
yeah,
me.
Yeah, no, I'm going to... Like, I mean, that might have even been the reason why I walked into the lounge and just started talking about my sexuality totally open, just in case somebody went through my my files or the government was watching me have a wank, uh-huh. I'd be like, yeah, I was doing that. That's I told you guys on September 12th.
I did, and I'm proud.
Yeah. I am. I totally
Before
am.
Before you walk into my house, there's a there's a picture of just a horse just getting
jerked off. Yeah.
I know. All right,
Sammy's obviously into bestiality, everybody.
You know what? This is actually, it's not really a segue, but whatever. I'm going to talk about it anyway. Yesterday at the office, we went to a new square, and we went to visit the Grand Mystic Poobah.
Explain that, please, because I don't know what that is.
The Grand Rabbi of New Square. Yeah.
Okay.
And
you saw a pedophile walking around.
Okay. So
this all ties into my last segment, everybody.
I love how casual that was. Oh, we saw a pedophile. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
You know how many pedophiles
it's
we probably run
in that
into?
Neighborhood.
Like,
yeah.
There's probably a lot of pedophiles that we run into. Hey.
How you doing? Nice to meet you.
Yeah.
Mm.
Where are the children?
Yeah. Well, at my age, 19-year-old is pedophile. So.
And
I don't have sex with 19-year-old virgins, but if you've had a go, then... Anyway.
Wow. I'd be surprised if a 19-year-old's a virgin these days, honestly.
That's part of the next segment.
So we went to New Square, and it really bothers me because I have, like, so many friends on Facebook who... are still kind of sexually immature in a way where it's like, ew, this stuff is gross. You know what I mean? Like anything, like you talk about like masturbation, ew, that's gross.
Yeah,
you talk
right.
about like, like sex that isn't like totally vanilla, ew, that's gross.
Yeah.
It's not natural. And I'm like, grow the fuck up. And just... And going to a place like New Square,
the repression is just going to take its toll on you in the weirdest way.
Yeah, and it's like
what's repressed is most likely to be acted out.
And my friends are
why shit's so weird in really conservative religious communities.
Most of my friends are like, are not from there. Most of my friends are just like normal, but they still have that sort of attitude. And I'm like, grow up. And like, you know what? I jerk off. And I am proud of it.
For
and
real,
you are
come on.
And you wanna I am you are not gonna stop me doing it. And to all the women who like try to talk me out of it, I'm gonna go home. jerk off and think about
to
you.
To all the girls I've loved so in my mind.
I'm gonna think about you deep throating me when I go home. How about that?
I dealt with
How
that.
About
I
that
dealt
shit?
With that.
Yeah.
I dealt with that recently, like over at the lounge, like I was flirting with this one girl. And she was just like, oh, you need to get away from me. Like, I am a child of God. And I'm just, I told
You're
her.
You're a child of God.
I told her, like, yo, look, listen, no one's too holy for
Give
dick.
Give me a call when you're a child
no one's
of sperm.
Too holy
no
for
one's
dick.
Too holy for dick, okay? Like,
I love that.
It's like,
I want to get that printed on a t-shirt.
Father, the Son, and the Holy Dick.
Yeah. Nobody, like, if. God made dick, right?
Or imagine
this is coming from the atheist.
I was
right?
talking to my stepdad like earlier.
It's
earlier
true,
week,
everybody.
God made dick.
Imagine.
Think about it.
Imagine if like the Virgin Mary was alive today. Like she would be on like the Jerry Springer show or like freaking Mari Povich or whatever. Like, and, like the tests are in. Like, the, you know, the results show that you are actually not a virgin.
Right. Like, go across the stage, just like,
What now? What now?
And Joseph being all like,
Oh my God,
like the Mari Povich, like, you told me you were a virgin. That would be a really uncomfortable at Mari.
Because I only thought of that because my stepdad, I walked in on him watching, like, Jerry Springer. And I'm like, why are you watching?
Is that like is that the
he
equivalent
was watching
of walking
like
in
an ironic sort of way, but like still I was like, why are you watching this?
You know what always
this
like,
is like the white trash.
Well, no, but dude, it was really funny because before I moved to England, I heard that Jerry Springer was the most popular show in England.
Yeah,
really.
And then I'm like, that's you know,
hysterical.
I thought there was like such an intellectual thing and a mystical thing about the UK.
No,
you
they
know,
just
with
like
the
all these fucking
and all
stupid
this.
Americans.
Yeah. So I end up hanging out with my first British friend, which took like a year because the Brits are such cunts. But anyway, Love you guys. But anyway, but yeah, and we roll a spliff and we're all watching and they're, oh, spring is on, mate. And I'm like, oh God, like, why do you guys like this? And then within 5 minutes, I was like, the joke is on me because they just started going like, is it really like that in America?
Yeah, like, exactly. They watch it like, are all Americans that stupid?
Yeah, like, yeah. Do you guys all have, like, are your suitcases... cases igloos with duct tape on. Like,
we are! And I have a closet full of jerry beads, okay? You fucking
clown. Like, I walk in on my stepdad, and he's like drugged up, and on the television is like, This fat woman gets rolled in on a table with like sushi and shit.
That sounds like the last 2 years of my last marriage.
These two like fat, like this fat guy and this other fat woman are like dripping food onto each other and like making out and like putting stuff in between their breasts. And I was just like looking at him like, I'm just gonna walk out now.
Wow.
You know,
it's like a father walking in on his son jerking off. Like, it's that level of awkward.
I would like to go and like, you know, go to a party and have it be like a Jerry Springer, like within the party. Cause then you have some shit to say, like, you know.
Yeah.
Like, I think it's pretty great. Like,
Well, do you guys ever see the Jerry Springer movie?
There's a movie?
There's a movie where they basically show all of the characters that they're cool and they're all on their way to the show. They get free plane tickets and blah, 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 blah. But then they start this, like, family thing where...
You have a knock on the door?
Oh, shit. I owe rent. This is my...
improv.
Let's go. No, but anyway. But yeah, just...
ignore the... noise.
There must be a pizza delivery going on. But anyway, they eventually... Yeah, nobody can hear that. That's the funny part. So I just look crazy. But all these families start getting into this. Like, there's a black family, a white family, and they just all get into these... they're, you know, from impoverished places. And it's so funny that by the time they finally get to the show, they're arguing so much that all Jerry Springer has to do is walk out. I actually had respect for him after that show because I went like, oh, this must happen all the time.
And what are they going to do? They're going to make like the Chris Hansen movie?
I don't know what that means.
Like, have you ever seen To Catch a Predator?
Yeah, right. Chris Hansen. Oh, okay. Wow. I was like, that reference.
Like, this summer, you're going to take a seat.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, you got it.
Then he comes like right from the theater like itself and it's just like he's looking at all the audience members. Just have a seat right there.
And he cheated on his wife, right? So like...
Did he?
Well, yeah, that's what happened to that guy.
Really?
Oh, that's what I thought the joke was. I'm sorry. I totally lost
that. Oh.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, but no, but he cheated. No. I mean, but no, seriously, he lost that show. Or I don't know if it's still on or whatever.
Did he cheat with one of the...
He ended up getting cheat and getting caught.
Oh, you know what would be funny? If he was on that other show, Cheaters. If they caught him on that show.
Just have Cheaters. A seat. Have a seat right there. Like, no, that's my line.
Did he cheat like with one of those child-looking actors that aren't children?
Oh my God, yes, yeah, I don't remember.
Because I would like to cheat.
This was like, I think this was like 2011.
Okay.
You would like to cheat.
Yeah, yeah, I would like to cheat on my wife with one of those like child-looking actors that aren't children. They're not children, so it's not weird, but they look like children.
Okay. Yeah, I did it.
This got very awkward very quickly.
I know. I dated a Russian girl that looked. She was 22, but I had to ask her for ID.
Over the place today.
Well, no.
We went from international politics to Jerry Springer.
Well, it's an international phenomenon.
Yeah.
But anyway, I actually have a top six list here.
Top six? Well, I hate top lists. It's so arbitrary.
No. It's there are things that I've been seeing recently, and I've just been studying it. Fuck you if you don't like top six. Get the fuck out of here.
Right. You're trying to think of a way.
I was going to explain myself, and I went, I don't owe you an explanation.
Fuck off.
But no, but these are, it just kind of turned into a top six list. And this ties everything in together. Politics, pedophilia, all of that stuff we're talking about today.
To a nice, neat little bow.
And these are the top six strangest things I've seen over the last couple weeks in...
In no particular order?
No. Snowdened on itself. All snowballed. Right. Snowdened. Yeah. Just felt like saying that. Pun.
That was clever.
Oh, thank you very much. Yeah, boy!
Chaco Blanca. Oh.
Flavor Flav up in this,
bitch. I was waiting for a chance to use that. It's at 6, too. So here we go. The 6 at 6. So.
Drop your tobacco shit.
Your shit. Oh.
Well, don't worry about it. We can worry about that later. So anyway, these are the top 6 strangest things I've seen on porn sites. The top 6 strangest descriptions.
Descriptions? Oh, no. You copied the descriptions?
Yes.
Oh, man, that is a great segment.
All right.
That's brilliant.
Now, I'm not going to letterman this. If you guys have anything to add.
Or?
No. These are actual descriptions.
Okay.
On Pornhub and X-Hamster.
Oh, man. I can't wait.
That I've been taking.
Let's do this.
And this is like just, look, people. I grew up. And I'm not going to, mention who is what and what's who, but I had 3 elders in my tribe, let's say.
Okay.
And I grew up in the age of porn mags. Right. There were VHSs, but, the elders were from another time.
Like when you open up the magazines themselves go wakatiko, wakatiko, wakatiko.
Sure, and they're sticky pages, and you just have to get over it.
You know what? Why has anyone never thought of, those porno mags, but you ever see those pop-up books?
Oh yeah,
that'd be a great idea.
Yeah, right.
Let's start telling that.
Like Uncle Wiggly's dick just comes hits you in the face. Anyway, Candyland. Candyland is just a big black pussy that just hits you in the face. I love it. Anyway, but the elders in my tribe, one of them was into Playboy, one of them was into Blacktail, and one of them was into Leg Show. So I do not discriminate on most things. Mm-hmm. Those 3 magazines cover all races, creeds, and perversions. So these are the type of things that I really don't understand. Because at the end of the day, I'm not into BDSM. I'm a kinky bastard. I'm a perverted bastard. But I love natural sex. I don't need any weird toys or anything weird kind of being...
I need
I think Millen...
I heard the word natural, and then I was like...
No, I think Michelangelo, you like the nut torture kind of stuff, don't you?
Oh, bring me a rodeo.
My nuts have been tortured for 23 years. What's a little more?
All right, but anyway... Here's my top 6. God, I wish this were Letterman's show. I need a drum roll.
Oh, yeah, I forgot that.
Well, yeah, we can't do that on the desk, though. All right. Here's the top 6 strangest description for a porn I've seen.
Yes, let's get right into it.
Girl on crutches, armpit sex.
Excuse me?
Girl on crutches, armpit sex. And these are the...
Did you watch these?
No. I chose these after I masturbated. And it's almost like when you go to...
You didn't want
to
waste your wank on crutches.
No. It's more like going to the... they say never shop on an empty stomach.
Huh.
So I made sure that I had my fun before... And I just look at the thumbnails just to see where they'd be going.
That's like so Willis logic.
Yes,
when it comes to porn.
to me, that first one sounds like she broke her legs and now
she was literally on crutches in a pink tank.
And you want to know what? I always like apply my Jewish logic to sex. It's like I never buy. I just look.
that's Michelangelo logic right there. Just as you pointed out the Willis logic, that's Michelangelo.
All right, let's do it. So what was
anything else about girl on crutches, armpit sex?
Well, she probably broke her legs, couldn't actually mount and fuck the guy, so it's just like get into my armpits, you know.
Well, what would that I understand the process, but I just don't understand the process of getting a woody A Woody Allen from that. Yes. Girl on Crutches Armpit Sex. That is just... I don't get it. I don't get it.
Was there two or one guy? Like...
No, I didn't even...
Just get both of them.
With the thumbnails, I just saw a girl, she hobbles into her apartment or wherever she was with her crutches, sits down at the computer, and then next thing you know, I think there was a...
Some guy just like...
There was just a penis
puts on it up her sleeve. Armpit.
Yeah, yeah, there you go.
Wow. All
right.
All right. All right. Are we ready for number five?
Yeah, please.
That was a solid 8 out of 10.
Brazilian mistress has farting orgasm in slave's face.
Slaves. Sorry.
That was literally a description I saw. Hey, now, hey.
Well, let's break that down. Brazilian mistress.
Look, I eat the booty like groceries.
Has
but
farting orgasm.
In slave's
in
face.
Slave's
Brazilian
face.
Mistress. Has farting orgasm in slave's face.
That sounds like the beer shits, really. Like,
I know, that's a very strange farting orgasm. I didn't know that there was such a thing. You can look at this stuff up, guys. This is you know, Pornhub, X-Amps, or whatever you're into.
Okay.
So,
ringing endorsement.
So, anybody have anything to say about that one?
That says it's, you know.
There's really nothing to say.
Yeah. I know. I mean, it's pretty much a self-descriptive description.
Yeah.
All right. Now, this is why I brought Harry O here today.
Oh, where is he?
Hold on. We have, wait for it. There was another one I saw, and it basically, it merely said, farts on teddy bear. And it was a bigger version of Harry O. And just all I saw was a white girl in panties and her butt facing the porch.
Oh, I've seen that one. I've seen that one. She's actually really good.
What? We watched it?
She looks good. She was twerking on the giant teddy bear.
It's okay, and, Harry O.
But wait.
She had a nice ass.
He's my therapy bear.
By the way, I farted on it before. It was under my butt the whole time.
I don't think she farted. Wait, read the description again. Read it.
It just says farts on teddy bear.
I don't think she farted on it. Well, it was late at night, so it was on mute, so I don't know.
All right. I saw that one today, and I thought it was hysterical.
Okay.
Okay.
I didn't see it, but I there you
thank
go.
You.
He looks sad.
He's
happy.
Certain no yeah, well, he'll be happy after he gets out of here today. All right, so anyway, number four was no, there's not a description for this, but this is
wait
something,
I thought that was number four.
That was number three. This is number four. Oh wait, hold on.
No,
you're
two,
three.
What order? Oh
yeah, yeah. No, this is four.
Okay.
Brazilian mistress has farting orgasm in slave's face. Number three is farts on teddy bear.
Oh, I thought you were counting down to one.
No. I'm going.
Oh, okay.
Oh, sorry. Oh, yeah. All right. So this is three. Sorry.
All right.
He's right, everybody. Sorry. It's just.
I was like, I thought like the more you go, the stranger it gets. Like.
But yeah, that's where we're going. This is number four, and or number three. Sorry, everybody.
Just go with it.
But anyway, this
are
was
you sure
a,
you don't have my stepdad's Percocet?
Oh my god, I wish. Anyway, this was a Vine that I saw, and it doesn't have a description. But this is just to show the devolution that we're experiencing with social media and all this stuff that's happening.
Oh, don't
this
tell
was
me it's like
a
social media based.
This was a Vine. That a girl that used to come to the lounge, really sweet girl. She was like 18 or 19. She was a virgin, and I don't know. I haven't checked yet. Yeah, because But anyway,
that's a great idea. I'm gonna sell virginity tests. I'll check with my penis.
Yeah, it's like a litmus configuration. So she came up to me one day at the lounge. And she had a Vine going on. And she said, what the hell is going on here? And the girl couldn't have been more than 13 or something like that. And she had, and I've told you about this. I think I might have told you too. There was a life-size SpongeBob with a dildo with a strap on dildo to it. And she was deep throating the dildo while SpongeBob was being played in the background.
You know what? Ever since you mentioned that,
and one she was video, going, "Yes, SpongeBob, I love you, SpongeBob. You're the greatest SpongeBob."
Who lives in a pineapple under the sea?
Well, I don't know anything about SpongeBob except that the production company that I worked at, we sold the Hawaiian music to them. But did you ever hear about this one?
Yeah, I remember you telling me it, and like it was probably so weird.
That's when I realized this is the decline of Western civilization.
I tried.
The punk music was fine.
SpongeBob roleplay.
Yeah.
I'll be SpongeBob. You be Squidward.
Oh man.
Ugh, yeah.
It was so weird.
And like I said, there was an episode.
Rub your tentacles on me.
There was an episode being played in the background. And it was probably, it was a disaster.
F is for friends who do stuff together.
What are some of those, like, voices from SpongeBob?
I can't really do it.
Yeah, I can't do any either.
Yeah, like SpongeBob, like,
yeah.
Like that.
That's what it was like when he skeeted.
When he skeeted.
All right. Are we done with that one?
I relate much more to Mr. Krabs. Like, I'm Mr. Krabs, and I like money. That's his shtick.
When you mentioned that, like, you know, like, I tried looking for it because it...
You tried looking.
Well, yeah, no, you...
God knows you tried.
That's why I'm sure it was completely taken off the internet at the right after it happened. And
but
I never tried to look for it again.
Yeah, exactly.
Today, I
never
reference.
Tried
what
looking for it
this?
Again. And then, like, it showed up recently, like, maybe, like, a few months ago as, like, I was scrolling through 4chan. And,
oh God! Well, 4chan's a type of place.
And I was just like, "What the fuck?" I was like, "There's that fucking video." But
you know, that's
GIF.
Actually a great idea. I wonder if 4chan has a board for like porn descriptions. I'm sure they have like porn boards. I'm sure.
Yeah, they have.
Porn. Well, yeah, but they have.
They're
know,
so into like.
It's far
feminine
more
feminine boys is what they're into.
Feminine boys.
Oh, yeah. You mean Twinkies? Twinks?
Yeah. Like traps. Ones that you think are like.
Why
girls,
am I not surprised?
But they're actually dudes.
Because that whole website is a trap.
Yeah, it is.
Wow.
And, like, I thought about it recently, and I'm like, you know, this is basically, like, reverse, like, you know, dyke, pretty much.
Reverse dyke.
Yeah, because, like, you think, like, they're dudes, but then, like, you realize, oh, shit, like,
the
there's a pair of tits on that.
LGBT community is going to be after us now.
And then, like, you know, with the chicks, it's just like, wow, look, that's a beautiful chick, but you're like, wow, there's a pair of balls on that. So...
Yeah. Oh yeah,
and Nambla, we're getting.
You know, after
we're
the
gonna
show,
have all the perverts after.
After the show, I'll reference you to some things. Okay.
The list isn't done, is it?
No, no.
Yeah,
we have two left.
Two.
We're on number two right now.
Okay.
I love this one. All right, we're done with the SpongeBob.
Yeah,
no, we're done.
Yeah.
All right, number two, Gilf gives
Gilf
head without dentures.
Oh that, wow. That's a professional one.
I wouldn't have it any other way. That's like what I would expect. Like,
I like how none of this. I haven't cursed once.
Yeah.
In this,
it would actually
segment.
Be a lot stranger with dentures.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it would.
Yeah.
I wouldn't know.
No, it's more like a lipper. Kind of like the dip you used to do in high school, but a lot different.
Oh god. That's,
but anyway, but awesome. First, like grandmas, I'd love to. I don't understand who has.
There's not a single grandma on the planet.
I know.
Unless like my supervisor's kid were to have a kid, like in the next couple days.
Mm. Like maybe Carol Burnett, just
I
for the hell of it, because she's so brilliant.
I think it's like. I think it's acquired taste, something that you get as you get older.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, of course, because if you're sitting there, you're probably like, like Ted Kaczynski if you're sitting there looking at your grandma. And
I can't imagine, though, being like 80 years old and like looking at pictures of like Betty White, you know what I mean?
Nah, yeah.
Like, I have to imagine, like, no matter how old you get, there's like a certain range.
No, I think what happens is just like... Where you begin at, you have that like sexual like preference for and shit like that. It's basically more just adds to that pile, and it gets bigger, basically.
It's
like
you're saying like say you never thought of that, but somewhere in your 20s, some woman who then again these days, you know, like they say 60 is the new 40 and that kind of stuff. So people can kind of maintain their looks in a different way these days as they never were able to.
Yeah, they got that
true.
Neutrogena
shit. So yeah, so say like there's like a grandma in her 50s.
Right.
And that's not old at all right now.
No.
Yeah.
No, because I think I may be talking to a woman.
Wait,
that's
is that
like
possible?
50. What
is that possible to be?
My father's
50s,
like
25, and then
yeah, my father, yeah, okay. My father's like 55,
wait, right?
And he's a grandfather.
Okay.
Yeah, so it's not possible. I mean, it's not impossible for a woman either. So.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
But yeah, like no, there are some hot 50-year-olds out there. And
well, there's some hot like 70-year-olds out there.
I'm just gonna move
the
on
the way you
to
maintain.
I don't know, man.
Yo, I definitely think you know they put out more than because I what I
they put out more.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, they definitely put a lot more out of their vagina.
I have done a case study on 70-year-old women.
I think so, man, because they don't got that golden vagina syndrome going for them.
They put out more, but
I have a curiosity.
I'm sure
what is golden vagina syndrome? I've never heard
that before in my life. Did you just make that up?
Golden vagina.
In the golden years of your life, your vagina is just allowed to do whatever it wants.
Golden vagina
it's
syndrome.
It's like college for old people. Like
golden vagina syndrome is when you think that
your vagina
your pussy
just watches Happy Days reruns.
Is when you believe your
you let your you let your vagina just watch Leave It to Beaver.
Oh, that was very clever.
Thank you very much. I'm glad you got it eventually. Yeah, boy!
So golden,
sorry, Harry.
Golden vagina syndrome is basically when you believe that your vagina is just too good for anybody to, like defile.
Okay. I've met a few.
Like,
defile.
Example, like, what I, like, said earlier, like, when,
it's like I'm Indiana Jones, like, raiding the temple.
When that girl told me, what is it, like,
being
you
chased
know,
by that
I'm
ball.
A child of God. There's a bit of you know golden vagina syndrome in there, and then
yeah. Oh, I get, I
yeah,
get you. I get
and it's just like yeah, like no, you're you know, no
you know,
one's too good for dick. Like,
yeah,
come on.
I'm sorry, your pussy's not that good.
Yeah,
it's good, but it ain't that good.
Yeah, so it's just like humble yourself a bit, like you know, your vagina's not made out of gold, it's bronze, just like anybody
it's
else's.
It's bronze,
right? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
it's very malleable.
All right. Well,
malleable. I've never heard that as an adjective.
We've got 1 minute. Well, we started 2 minutes late today, so it's 4:59. So now we have 1 minute for the number one.
Yeah, let's do it.
And this one is husband watches wife get destroyed by BBC. Now, if I remember correctly, that has something to do with Charles and Diana, right?
I don't know.
That's reverse cock, right?
Come on, guys. You didn't get that joke.
Not again.
Husband watches wife get destroyed by BBC.
Oh. Oh.
Oh.
Okay. Yeah.
Now
I get it. Yeah.
And on that note, people.
Well, wait.
Oh, wait.
Oh, you had other shit. But we don't
oh, yeah. No, that's not. This is number one right here.
Oh yeah, I guess that's a pretty good way to go out.
Yeah, it was kind of like the Letterman top 10. The last one is not really worth a response. It's more worth
play
a
me
reaction. Yeah, right. But anyway, yeah. So we're at 5 right now. Does anybody have any parting words?
It's good to be back. Really enjoyed being on the show, and hopefully we're gonna deliver a lot more awesome stuff your way.
Yeah. I miss having this crew on.
Yeah.
I miss, I definitely miss Jairo and...
Choco Blanca.
And Choco Blanca. And they're kind of off and doing their own thing right now. So hopefully we have them back soon. And...
No one's too good for dick.
No one's too good for dick.
Yeah.
All
right. That's what I'm going out at.
All right. I'm going to go home and I'm going to jerk off and I'm going to be proud of it.
Sammy. We got the metrosexual and the pervert here. Flavor Flav, everybody.
We are changing of the guards.
We are changing of the guards. Our producers.
I guess we got more airtime.
It looks like it too. You know what? I'm just gonna start
We're
eating.
We're doing it live.
We're doing it live. I'm gonna just gonna start eating pizza. Do you guys?
This segment
have
of the show is just where Willis eats pizza and we watch.
Everybody,
we watch a slice of pizza get destroyed by BBC. I was like, but that's, I mean, I get it was a joke. But
that's
I mean,
a good joke. Shut up.
But I mean, that's just
this
like.
This is the post show show.
Like, this is the post show.
Yeah. We're not really friends.
We
guys.
Should get, like, another thing of alcohol if we ever decide to do a post show.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you know, usually I have a lot more alcohol here, but.
I mean, like, that's like cuckold shit.
It is.
I don't understand anything about cuckold stuff, and that's why it surprises me.
You know what really annoys me? Like, I hear that all the time now. You know what I'm talking about? Like, oh, this guy's a cuck. That guy's a cuck. Like, it's such like a specific thing.
Yeah.
And like,
you know what I noticed in porn?
I never understood it.
Like, and this is like, I felt like there was like a like almost like an evolution in the porn industry that happened. Like, all of a sudden, like, I'm watching porn, everything's fine. Then now, like, every porn video I come across, like, you know, porn stars are now, like, shoving their feet in the camera.
Okay.
Yeah, like, now everything's
becoming
like
a... But that's
not a
weird thing.
No, it's not.
Foot fetishes have always happened.
It's not, but, like, now...
When I was younger, I didn't see armpit sex magazines.
I never seen, like feet, like, foot fetish, like I told you. It's, like, put out now.
Okay, yeah, yeah. It might be a little weird. Oh, yeah, another weird thing I saw, and this is going to make me nauseous because I'm eating, is there was one thing that said, eat the dust off my feet. You know, she was a girl with really dirty... Off? Yeah, she had really dirty feet,
oh, that's nasty.
And there was a guy sucking on her. It was so gross.
Because when I went to camp for a week, and I was wearing my sandals.
This one time at band camp?
At Jew camp. Like, what? That came out wrong.
Go ahead.
I was walking around in sandals and my feet were all dirty and it was like disgusting. Oof. Like, I wouldn't want to put anyone through.
Yeah.
Sucking my dirty.
Like what I want to hear after like that.
No, porn. That's not the point. The point is there's somebody gross enough to
deal
with. Be turned on by that. Girl on crutches, armpit sex. Are you kidding me? Yeah, does that turn you on at all?
Like what I want to hear, like when like things like that happen, like in the porn set, like eat the dust off my feet. It's just like a pause on the screen, and then just like in like you know, just like script letters across the screen, like what would you do for a Klondike bar? And it's just like that's what I want to see every time in cursive, just like and like stars and just what would you do for a Klondike bar?
Wait a minute. By the way, did you guys? I know this is a little off topic, but did you guys see that that video about? Hip hop in the year 2020, and that's in that goofy ass Russian dude who's dressed like he's in a like a
oh, and he's going like.
Do you know how many times I watched that and laughed my fucking ass off?
Does he have like starfish? Like on
yeah,
the
he's got like he looks like it's like Ziggy Stardust without the songwriting, and he's actually really talented.
Yeah,
his voice just
I've
hits
heard,
these.
Yeah.
But it's like blah 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 blah. It's the strangest thing, and the way he's dancing, it's the whitest thing I've ever seen
in my
life.
He has like what is it, like spark flare like things, like and he's just like waving them around.
I don't know, but
yeah, he's got like this like onesie jumpsuit thing.
In the hip hop 2020 thing, there's a guy who looks exactly like Hitler, in this. No, he's got like a fabulous scarf and stuff like that, and he just goes.
So
right in the beginning of that,
hip hop is going to be dominated by metrosexual like Hitler
Nazis.
Okay,
basically
they come again.
Yeah, they come again. Anyway, guys, I mean this is free reign.
Yeah.
So just go for it. What is anything you guys want to talk about that's happened? That's.
I was just saying.
Yeah. I have bits, but they're gonna. They would take like 15 to 20 minutes.
Yeah,
like the last one.
We'll save them. Yeah. I mean, I don't know. I get annoyed by people that just sort of have the same talking points like over and over and over. And over.
Like,
how did you like the top six?
Like,
today?
No, like, I was
good,
like,
right?
like the whole cuck thing. Like,
oh, that know, thing. Yeah, yeah.
Like it's people, like, I don't know. People don't really have any like original.
Mm-hmm. Like, I want to hear someone call me like you know, like as a curse word, like sloppy horse cock or something like that. Like, yeah.
Or like, yo, bitch tits.
Yo. Yeah, exactly.
Like, what up?
What's up, bitch tits?
Yeah, boy!
Mario feels, like, violated. Like, I don't know if you saw me earlier, but I was like...
His eyes aren't happy.
I was like...
Girl
I
fights
had him,
on teddy bear. No, look.
You see the sadness. No, the sadness in his eyes.
I had...
You
no,
see
because
now, though.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
I had him, like on my crotch, just, like, bobbing his head up and down. Like.
Oh, yeah. He just had to give Millen
A quickie,
so.
Yeah, it's not really.
Boo!
What's his name?
Harry Obiebie.
Harry
Obiebie?
Yeah.
What is that?
That's a stupid nickname my ex-wife and I used to call each other. You remember that?
Okay. Well, like, I thought
bastard.
It was like culturally influenced or something. Like, it must have been.
Oh,
like,
Harry O is actually the guy who helped Suge Knight. Fund Death Row Records.
Okay.
I guess I could just, like, go to Google and look up news.
But wait, so, yeah, I mean, that's there's really nothing fun. You could really say about that, the guy who... Wait, Rich, are you there? I think Rich left us alone. Dude,
that's
the
fine.
Inmates have taken over the prison, everybody.
Nice.
Yeah, we have taken over the asylum. let's see.
The asylum, sorry. Sorry, you work with...
While you're looking up news, I'll probably talk about how I was sexually harassed at work, I guess, right?
Yeah, talk about that.
Right? So, yeah, like...
I was sexually harassed at work, too.
Not going to name any
names. My supervisor keeps flashing her boobs in my face.
Flashing?
Yeah.
Or do you mean just looking provocative?
This is something
I
wanted to say, too.
Yeah, flashing is a different thing. I don't think you'd be sexually harassed. You would just start motorboating like a fucking...
Yeah, she doesn't.
That's fine.
Boobs.
That's okay.
That's harassing.
But anyway, go ahead.
Well, like, I wanted... Before that little thing, I wanted to say that the... What is it? That the Jewish women in Muncie, they have, like, nice asses. It's great.
All right.
I just wanted to say that the Jewish women...
You need a black woman in your life.
No, but they...
Rich, are we... What's going on?
No, you'd be surprised.
Well, we're still talking. We're still bantering.
give a shout-out to the end of the show.
Give a shout-out to the end of the show. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to save Sammy's sexual harassment case until after his lawyer talks to him.
Yes.
And his therapist.
That's
both
this guy over here.
Yeah. I'm his lawyer. He's his therapist. And I'm his...
You give me all the juicy details.
What am I talking about? Anyway, this is Changing of the Guards.
Changing of the Guards, signing out.
My name is Willis. This is The Wrath of Khan. This is Michelangelo. We'll be back next week. At least the three of us will. You know what time it is. Yeah. Signing out. This is Harry Obiebie as well. I hope you guys enjoyed our top six list today.
Boy. No one's too good for dick.
Boy. No one's too good for dick.
All right, you gotta calm down with that. Born Again.
It's not just radio, it's Rockland World Radio. RocklandWorldRadio.com.